Hey guys, it's Mo from Paper Hearts, and oh my god, it's been a cool minute since I've uploaded. Haha! As you can see, there's some changes in my space, such as I'm in a different space. I was in this room last time, but I had, like, the camera at, like, this weird angle, like, here, because I had nowhere to prop it up. But now I got a bed, I have my friends in my background, and I also went purple! So, it's been a crazy couple months, just like, talk about that real quick. It's just been really crazy. I had finals, I just finished school year, I had competitions, I had championships for Color Guard, I had state solo and ensemble for my woodwind quintet. It was pretty cool. But, I'm not here to talk about these past couple months, I'm here to talk about my life. So I'm a very clumsy person. I fall probably on average about 10 times a day. So I fall quite a lot. Well, let's see. A few days ago, well, almost a week ago actually, my friends texted me and they were like, hey, let's go to Six Flags. So a spontaneous trip to Six Flags. Whatever. So we get up there, we're on the ride up there, I'm DJing and I'm playing all of our favorite songs, we're having fun, we pull up, we go there, everything's fine. So first we go on Tatsu. So for those of you who haven't been on Tatsu, it's four people, you get in like this, there's like a little step thingy and like, it's like this, like there's a slant flat where you walk, and another slant, and then there's a seat thing so you can stand on the flat part and get into the seat. And then once you're on the ride like this, you lay face down and go, like, laying facing towards the ground. So I get off the ride, and I'm dizzy. And so I fall on my butt. In front of a lot of people. A lot of people laughed. So I'm red-faced, and like, oh my god, I can't believe I just fell. My friends are like, oh no, it's fine, whatever. So I get back up, whatever, go walk around the park, we go on a couple other rides. Then we get in line for Batman. So, if you haven't been on Batman, the way it goes is you walk through Gotham City Park, walking up to it, and then you walk through this tunnel thing, and then there's steps, and it's like going to the Batcave, essentially. And on the stairs, so there's like two really cute guys behind me. And so it's these two cute guys, their dad, then me and my two friends. So my friend loses signal, and she's like, damn it, I lost signal. And the dad goes, oh, wow, you, teenagers, wow, yada, making jokes about how she can't live without a phone. So she takes the next step up, and she trips, or she loses her footing, but she doesn't fall. So we're like, oh, wow, she's so lost without her phone that she can't even walk, ha, ha, ha. And then I go and take a step and fall on my butt in front of the two cute guys, in front of a lot of people. So, and it's always something like that, because I'm always like, wow, it's karma always comes and bites me in the ass really quickly. Like, I bought this brand new case from the Disney store. I love Disney. So I got this really cute case. I was like, wow, $30 case, my phone's not going to break now. I don't know if you can see it, but all that stuff right there, yeah. It's missing glass out of the screen right there. Karma comes and bites me in the ass very quickly. Another time I fell in public. I was in Color Guard in 8th grade. We had a performance at our local college, like our local, like, city college. It's like something that they do every year, whatever. So we got invited to perform. I fell in front of one of the best, if not the best, color guard in the entire world. I fell. On my face. Like, I used to have a scar for, like, a good year, two. It just barely started fading a few months ago, and now it's like, but, like, right here, I used to have scars from physically, boom, scratching my chin on the floor. I fell in front of one of the world's best color guards. When I was little, I would always fall, and, like, my family tells me, like, they'd hear, like, crash, bang, boom. Mo-amote. And I've always had really bad vision. When I got my eyes checked when I was in fourth grade, they told me, "Oh, wow, like why are you in here? You don't need glasses." I was like, "You're crazy. I can't see anything on the board. It's cool." And they were like, "Okay, we'll talk to your uncle." And they told my uncle, "I'm just faking it because I want glasses." Newsflash, I hate glasses. I'm wearing contacts. So the next year, like fifth grade, I go to a different optometrist because I got different insurance through my family member's work. I go, and the first thing they do is said, "Have you ever had glasses before?" I'm like, "No." And they're like, "You should. Your eyes are terrible." I'm at in minus 3 and a minus 3.25 because I have slight astigmatism in this eye. I'm at a minus 3. That's pretty bad. Not horrible, but it's not good. So little old me, like, I just walk in with big old glasses one day. It was glamorous. I'm still clumsy, but I used to, like, straight up just, like, bang into walls. Like, here's a wall, I'd just be walking and I would slam into it. But now that I've actually, like, had depth perception, I could be like, "Oh, wow, there's a wall there. Let me walk not into it." And so my optometrist just tried telling me, like, "Oh, yeah, you're faking it." But ever since I got contacts slash glasses, when I was little, I used to fall everywhere. Just like I would stand up and trip. I went to Knott's Berry Farm when I was little, and I didn't see that there was a like curb. I fell off and ate crap. Simple as that. And so I got contacts and glasses, and my life just became so much easier. But I still fall, and just like I did at Six Flags. Another time, I was at Disneyland. My band travels to Disneyland every year to do a workshop. I was at the workshop behind this, like, we got to go behind the scenes where no one gets to go except for like the cast members. It was really cool. Like, you got to see like all the behind the scenes things. We got to actually sit in a recording room where they recorded sounds for Moana. So it was pretty cool. Like, not gonna lie, going behind the scenes, it's definitely an experience. It's definitely something. So I'm back there with all the cast members, people who like are official Disney workers, and they have like painted like yellow lines that you have to stay the like sidewalks just because there's a lot of cars and trucks moving behind there, just like transporting things behind the scenes. I tripped in front of Alice. I tripped in front of the person that's Alice. She was walking and she was like, "Oh, hi guys." Just like being, a Disney cheery person. And I turn and I'm like, "Oh, hi." And then I tripped over my own 2 feet. There wasn't even anything on the ground. I just tripped over my own 2 feet. I have so many scars, bumps, and bruises up and down my arms. Like, just today I fell off my chair. I wasn't doing anything. I was taking my final and I stood up. And like my foot got caught like behind the chair leg, and I just pummeled into the wall because I sit in like the corner, like here's the wall, here's my desk, and I just pummeled into the wall while everyone was still taking their finals. Cause I'm dumb. So that's just my little story time of my experience of public embarrassment. All right, well, I'm a peace out. Make sure you guys like this video if you want more videos like this. Comment down below anything you want to tell me or any video suggestions. Make sure you subscribe and click the bell so you get notified every time I post a new video. And remember, hearts are as fragile as paper, so be careful which ones you go and rip. All right, mwah, I will see you all next time. Bye!